claim your righteousness, if you commit yourself and humble yourself to his laws, statutes, and commandments. Go to Numbers chapter 15. Let's touch on some of God's commandments.
We're gonna start living God's laws, stop living man's laws.
That's right. A lot of people out here living man's laws, because everybody, they complain about oppression from the white man, but they about to go celebrate his Independence Day next month. What type of sense does that make?
School teacher, government's teacher. That's
go ahead.
They don't teach you nature's law.
Numbers chapter 15 and verse 38. Speaking to the children of Israel, and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generations.
So the brother was telling you, so-called blacks and Latinos, we are the real Jews. So that means this commandment applies to us. We got to put fringes upon the border of our garments, right? Go ahead.
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
That's why you see every brother up here with that. That's something you don't have on, brother. Something you got to add to all your garments. Got to increase that righteousness.
Hey, I cover your garments up. Real garment is the righteousness.
But he told you that to be righteous, you got to keep his laws. His law said put something on your garment that you don't have on your garment.
What did Adam say?
What'd he say?
He said, forgive me for I have sinned. Without your forgiveness, I will not be saved. I repent to you.
So that's your excuse?
So he didn't put on his clothes. He was already seen. He repented. He didn't put on no clothes, no garment. His garment was inside.
So you saying the law is inside of us?
It's inside.
You sure?
Yeah, that's the garment.
Give me Leviticus 19:27. We're going to bring out some of these laws that God told us to keep.
Oh, I know the law.
Leviticus 19:27. Go ahead.
Leviticus chapter 19 and verse 27. You shall not round the corners of your head. Neither shalt thou mar the corners of thy beard.
So God, dealing with the men, he said you can't be cutting off your beard. I see a lot of bald-headed brothers going by. That's not lawful according to the laws of God. He said you got to keep your hair, right? Go ahead.
You shall not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead, nor print any marks upon you.
Because everybody, they glorify these rappers, right? Try to get tattooed like them because, you know, the women like it. But the women, they like ungodly men. God said, you shall not make cuttings in your flesh for the dead, nor print things upon your body. Read it again.
You shall not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead, nor print any marks upon you.
No scarification, no tattoos, no balding of your face, no balding of your head. See, God said his laws aren't grievous, but we have to humble ourselves and then submit ourselves to him and him only. You can't say you love God today, but you're trying to hook up with all these women and then be in church tomorrow talking about, I love Jesus. God is the way and the truth. But you're not living in his truth. What is truth according to the Bible? Let's get it for you. We about to get what the truth is according to God. Go ahead and get that. You know where it's at? Go ahead.
Psalms chapter 119 and verse 142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth.
God's laws are the truth. Everything that nobody wants to follow. You try to tell our people the laws, they say, brother, that was done away with. But you're still giving your pastor law tithes, which is a law of the Old Testament. You try to tell your people, keep God's laws. You don't have to no more, brother, the law's in my heart. Jesus died for our sins. So you telling me you can sin more? That's not what the Bible tells you to do. Let's get that. Yeah. Oh, go ahead, get it.
James chapter 1 and verse 22. But be ye doers of the word and not hearers only.
See, God said be a doer of the word. Don't just walk around and say you love Jesus and you love God, but you have to do what?
Be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves.
Deceiving your own self. Our people, we don't like to have a mind for ourselves no more. We look to ungodly men to give us our advice. We look to people like Lil Wayne, people like Lil Chucky, Lil Irv, Future. These are the people our young men go to get advice on how to live their lives. So I guess pouring lean, popping pills, that's the way? That's the long way we came since Dr. King? Would y'all think we came a long way? Y'all here for the BET experience? Nah, what y'all here for? Buy you some shoes?
Nigger car.
You should come listen to this word, bro. We finna get deep, man.
Gotta go to work.
All right, man. Today's the Sabbath day. Go to Genesis chapter 2. Today's the Sabbath day. No work is to be done. No buying, no selling, no cooking with heat. No type of work. Go ahead.
Genesis chapter 2 and verse 2. And on the seventh day, God ended his work, which he had made. And he rested on the seventh day from all his work, which he made. And God blessed the seventh day.
You see, God blessed the seventh day. Saturday, the seventh day of the week. The day so-called blacks and Latinos are supposed to be keeping holy. Not no more. Not here in America. Not in 2016. That's not good enough. Our people say, man, Lil Wayne is more important than keeping God's laws. I want to experience what BET is like. He said, I like foolishness. That's what our people say. Go ahead.
Thank you. Sorry.
And God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it he had rested from all his work which God created and made.
Give me Exodus 31:14. See, our people, we don't fear God. Fear is not taught here in America. They teach you to fear the white man more than God. Because you'll break the Sabbath day before you'll run a red light. He said, I'd rather send my soul to hell than get a ticket. That's what our people say. Our people don't fear God. You know why? Because our people don't read the Bible. Give me Revelations 1 and 3 first. We don't read God's word. We truly don't know what God's word says. If I ask the normal Christian, the Christian, to name me the Ten Commandments, they'll name about five and they'll give up. You know the Ten Commandments? No, where my Christians at? Brothers right here on the corner, y'all Christians? People walking up, are y'all Christians? Go ahead and read that, all right?
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 3. Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein.
See, blessed is the man that read. You like to read the Bible, bro? That's good, man. We gotta tell our other brothers and sisters to tag along. Blessed is the man that reads the word of God and then does the things that he asks of you. Very simple. If we kept God's commandments, there'd be no such thing as black on black crime. If we kept God's commandments, we wouldn't have to rally and march in the streets for black justice. Because we will be ruling as God intended for us to do. Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Let me show you truth according to the Bible. Go ahead, all right.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Who is this talking about? Did God say everybody in the world is holy? Go to Deuteronomy 1 and 1. God's going to tell you who a holy and special people is unto him.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Talking to the Israelites. Go back to chapter 7. Read.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Brothers and sisters right here on the corner. God said you're a holy people unto him. Read.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee.
He chose you.
To be a special people unto himself.
He said he chose you to be a special people unto himself, right?
Above.
The same.
Above.
Equal to.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
So sisters, why do y'all try so hard to look like this white woman? Oh, a lot of heads turned then. Don't look surprised. Y'all like to get the blonde weaves, throw in the contacts. Y'all don't like getting them tans. Y'all laugh because you know it's true. Our people hate ourselves. When God said that we are holy and special people unto him above everybody else. What's going on with that? What, am I lying? That's good. Look at Queen Latifah. Back in the days, dark skin, wear the curly hair. Now she whitewashed, wearing blonde weave. Same thing with Beyonce on Negro Sellout Self. Rihanna, look at all the pictures. They whitewashed. Blonde hair. What's going on? But read that again. I don't think they heard it.
Deuteronomy 7 and 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
See, God chose us to be a special people unto himself. So why don't our people carry ourselves in that way? Young brothers, they don't care about themselves no more. Not as a whole. They said, I'm about to go sell some sneakers so I can look good. So I can go and prostitute some of my sisters. Lay with them, make them whores. They're not saying, how can I raise some money to build our nation? They're saying, how can I get that jag? How can I come up, right?
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
That's right. Give me Isaiah 58 and 1. See, this is what we got to do out here.
Isaiah chapter 58 and verse 1. Cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgressions.
So we got to come out here, we got to show our people our transgressions. But nobody like getting told about themselves. All my brothers right here, I got to let y'all know that if y'all buying, selling, working on the 7 day of the week, which is today, you breaking God's laws. You getting them boosy fades, you cutting off your manly beard, you breaking God's laws. Sisters, if you out here prostituting yourselves, you breaking God's laws. All them weeds, man. We got to get everybody though, brothers and sisters. There's a lot more to it. If you over there smoking weed, getting leaned out, popping them pills, you breaking God's laws. If you prostituting your sisters, talking about rap, saying ain't nothing more worth than just shaking booty, you breaking God's laws. This is what our people need. We don't need no more free concerts. We don't need no more rap music. We don't need no more Jordans. We need God's laws. Give me that Deuteronomy 30. I believe it's 31 and 2.
1 and 2.
Yeah, give me that. Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 31.
No, 30 verse 1.
Verse 30. Chapter 30 verse 2. And shall return unto the Lord thy God, and shall obey his voice, according to all that I command thee this day, thou and thy children.
So God said we have to return to him, right? Keep his laws. Go ahead.
With all thine heart and with all thy soul, that then the Lord thy God will turn thy captivity.
He said, until you do that, he's not going to take away your captivity. That's why you're still getting gunned down in the streets. That's why you're still working them long hours at your job. Barely have time to raise your kids. You can't educate them properly. Malcolm X said only a fool will let his children get taught by the oppressor. But that's what we do. And then be proud to say, my son is a graduate from USC. You telling me you got a doctor's degree and you still calling yourself black, which is a color? What have you learned? Nothing at all. This is why we got to come out here and give our people the truth. We're not coming to you bringing you lies saying, God knows our heart. Everybody's saved. We're not coming to tell you that. Our people don't know what's coming to America. Death and destruction. Do your pastor ever go into the prophecies that Christ was talking about? Matthew 24? You should read it. Then you'll understand why you got gators eating kids, gorillas beating up kids, why God is getting flooded, why you got 50 homosexuals getting gunned down in the club.
Uh-huh.
Because God's bringing judgment to this earth.
Uh-huh.
Something your pastor's never going to teach you. You know why? Because he's pimping you, taking your money.
Go ahead.
Sad part is some of y'all shaking your head saying, yeah, I know, but you still going that. Because you need that high. Got to get some of that spiritual crack. Because then when you step back into reality, then you go to the weed. You said it's too much for me to deal with. And then when you don't have that, they got the BET experience for you to go to. So you can see your favorite sellout rappers. Give me Mark 8:36. Everybody want to be rich, not even knowing what that comes with in this wicked world. First, give me Job 9:24. Let me tell you a little something about this earth we live in right now. It's wicked, and the people ruling it are wicked. Do black people run this earth? No. Do Latino people run this earth? No. The same people that run this earth, the same people that's throwing you this BET experience. And you eat it up. You love it. But go ahead.
Job chapter 9, verse 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
Uh-huh.
He covereth the face of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he?
Sister, who runs this earth right now? I'm talking to you. Black people don't run this earth. White folk rule this earth. That's why he said it's given into the hand of the wicked. But our people, we steady run into this white man for everything that we truly don't need. What you need a rap contract for? You don't. You need to be out here resurrecting your people, building your nation back up. Now give me that Mark 8:36.
Mark chapter 8, verse 36. For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world?
What shall it profit a man if he has all the riches in the world?
And lose his own soul.
And loses his own soul in the process of that. All these rappers you love to sing their lyrics, go see in concert, they all sold out. Do y'all know what that means for them to sell out? People talk about the Illuminati all the time. Oh, Illuminati, look, pyramids, triangles. They take our people. Effeminize the men. They get our women. They prostitute our women. Set them at odds against each other. They rap about killing, selling drugs, when they're not doing none of that. Then our young brothers who hear that in the hood, they say, you know what, I don't want to live that lifestyle. They pick up the guns. They start whipping them bricks. Our sisters, they see Nicki Minaj up there. They said, all I gotta do is show a little booty to get some money? White man said, yeah, baby, that's all you gotta do. Running straight to them, not even realizing a trap. Give me Leviticus 20 and 13. Lil Wayne, Future, Wiz Khalifa, all giving up their booties for some money.
That's right.
And y'all wanna line up and go see them.
That's right.
Then y'all follow their trends. Brothers wearing these tight, what do they call them? Joggers. Look like they're wearing sweaters on their legs. Looks foolish as hell. What you trying to do? Go ahead, Doc.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13. If a man also lie with mankind as he lies with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination.
Man, God saying these rappers are sold out. They ain't worth nothing. It's more to life than what's going on right here. Said if a man lies with a man as he would with a woman, go ahead.
They shall surely be put to death.
That's why God is not for homosexuals. That's why God is not for LA pride, gay pride. That is a sin, a major one. Go ahead.
Their blood shall be upon them.
And their blood shall be upon them. As much truth as we speaking out here, we shall have a long line. Why are people don't want to hear it? And y'all getting it from both ways. We got brothers down there, and we right here. And some more down there. Are you listening? What we talking about, man?
This is some real shit.
You gonna get with it? That's right. Hey, but come check it out, bro. Come check it out.
I'll be right back, my nigga.
All right, hey, but check it out. What's your nationality?
Black.
You black? Your skin is brown. So what you talking about?
Yeah, yeah.
This is what we got to get to our people. We not black. We not African. We not Negroes. We Jews.
That's right.
Brothers right here, what's up, man? Come get with us. Blacks and Latinos, we the real Jews.
Donald Trump.
Bro, YD and them the truth, too.
He said Donald
Trump. We the real Jews.
He said Donald Trump.
Man, to hell with Donald Trump. We ain't worried about none of that. So-called Latinos, you not Mexican. You not Puerto Rican. You are a Jew, according to the Bible.
Right.
Give me Song of Solomon 1 and 5. Hey, man, I hope y'all listening. Hey, I see you, my boy. Hey, you in the industry, but check it out, man. You are a Jew, bro. Hey, tell Wiz, all them Jakes, you are a Jew. Ty Dolla Sign heard the truth today. He is a Jew. So guess what? When God come and judge, and he ain't found keeping them laws, he has no excuse. Go ahead and read that for me.
Ezekiel chapter 2 and verse 7. And I shall speak my words unto them.
We gonna speak God's words unto you.
Whether they will hear or whether they will forbear.
Whether you gonna hear us or whether you gonna roll up your window and continue in your vanity, we gonna still teach you this truth. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
For they are most rebellious.
See, our people, we most rebellious.
These jackasses.
Look at this. Our people, man.
That ain't ours.
I know, but I'm talking about our people. Says we most rebellious. We could be out here teaching all day and we would have heathens listen before the actual people we teach it to is listening. What is going on? Go ahead.
Verse 17, chapter 3, Son of man, I made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, hear the word out of my mouth and give them warning from me.
See, God made us a watchman to you brothers right here. We gotta tell you, we gotta warn you straight from God that if you don't fix your life, you're gonna go to hell. We don't want that for none of our people. Unfortunately, as the scripture just said, our people is most rebellious. We don't wanna listen to God. Give me Isaiah 30 and 9. Our people don't listen to truth. They caught up buying Jordans. Go ahead,
Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 9. That this is a rebellious people, lying children, children that will not hear the law of the Lord.
You see, the children, they don't want to hear God's laws.
Right.
I was talking to a brother, man. I said, I just understand why our people, we don't want to understand truth. You know what he told me? He said, truth be told, our people hate God. And they actually show it every day.
Just go until they go. Yeah.
We went to the BET Free Fan Fest last week. I was talking to two Christian women. She was talking about how she's so in love with God and know the commandments. Yet when a sister said she was an atheist, she started laughing it up with her. You're supposed to correct that sister, tell her no. Submit yourself to God's laws. But see, Christians, they really don't believe in the Bible. Ask the most devout Christian, who did Christ come to save?
The world.
They say Christ came to save everybody.
The
Do you
world.
Think Christ came to save everybody? Yes or no, sis? You think Christ came to save everybody?
She says she don't know.
She don't know? Brother right here. Brother right here.
Where?
Oh, go ahead. Yeah, sure is, huh? Hey, tell your daddy he a Jew. He probably already know. Go ahead and read that.
Acts chapter 5, verse 30. The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom you slew and hanged on a tree. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior for to give repentance to Israel.
You see, God raised up Jesus Christ to give deliverance and a chance to repent unto the children of Israel. You know the children of Israel are? Who cares, right? He said, brother, I got some weed in my pocket. I ain't tripping. That's why Christ had to come. Because our people are destroyed. They needed a second chance. Our young sisters out here prostituting herself at a young age.
Right.
I'll be walking around seeing daughters with their moms. And but how you gonna let your daughter come out the house dressed like that? Like she going to the toddler club or something. It's crazy. People who say black power. I got love for my nation, but they'll sit there and smoke a cigarette in front of an infant. That stuff is crazy to me. I don't understand it. And then nobody speaks up on it like it's just cool. What's going on? I'm gonna tell you what's going on. Our people living wickedly. We have to come back to God's laws. We gotta read first off, learn who we are. Give me Deuteronomy 10 and 1. No, 10 and 12. Know what's required of you by God. It's not enough just to say you love him. It's action with that. Go ahead, Ot.
Deuteronomy chapter 10 and verse 12. And now, Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
I'm going to tell you what God requires of all you so-called blacks and Latinos standing here right now. Go ahead.
But to fear the Lord.
Fear the Lord.
Thy God, to walk in all his ways.
You got
to
walk in all his ways. You can't pick and choose. Go ahead.
And to love him and to serve the Lord thy God with all thine heart and with all thy soul.
We got
to
serve God. We can't serve ourselves. We got to become selfless. Start caring more about our people. Tell them they got to stop living their wicked ways. Tell our brothers, man, stop throwing money at our girls for stripping. Correct them, sisters. Tell them put some clothes on. Become shamefaced. Throw a dress on. Wrap her head up. Read the Bible. Pray to the Most High God.
There you go.
Tell our brothers, stop sagging your pants because that's homosexual.
Go ahead.
Nobody else want to see your ass.
Go ahead.
Tell our brothers, stop tattooing your bodies up. Tell our brothers, stop gangbanging. Stop killing your brother for no reason. If you want to kill somebody who's killing you, go kill that white man.
That's right.
Go ahead.
That's right.
Tell our brothers, become masculine. Learn God's word and teach our people. Get us up out of this hell. Because guess what? The saints of the Most High God, they're going to take the kingdom. We're not asking to be liberated. When the Most High God gives us that power, once we're only going to get when we become righteous, we've taken the world. And nobody going to stand in our way. Thus saith the Lord. Give me Revelations, chapter 2, verse 9. Let me show you something Christ said. Go ahead, Ot.
Revelation, chapter 2 and 9. I know thy works and tribulation.
Hey, check this out, sis. Listen carefully. Go ahead, read it again.
From the top.
I know thy works and tribulation.
and poverty. Christ said he knows our works. He knows our tribulation. He know we getting gunned down in the street. He know we getting oppressed by this white man. And he said he knows our poverty. Go ahead.
But thou art rich.
We are rich because we are the children of the Most High God. We carry his spirit. And when we become righteous, we gonna rule this world. Go ahead.
And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews.
And he knows the blasphemous lies, the blatant lies that the white man says, talking about he's a Jew. Go ahead.
The blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
They are the synagogue of Satan. That's why you're getting treated the way you are. Go ahead.
Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer.
Go to 3 and 9.
3 and 9, behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie.
See, he said when he come back, he gonna make all those fake Jews who claiming to be you, because believe it or not, black and Latino man, you are the real Jew. Look what he said he gonna do to them fake Jews when he come back.
Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet.
They gonna bow down and worship you at your feet because y'all the real kings and queens of this earth. So why we come here to BET Experience to see our people act a fool?
Go ahead.
All we worth is just twerking. Is that all sisters is good for is twerking? Our brothers, all we good for is just trend setting with clothes? No, we supposed to be setting trends for the world in righteousness. But our people, we don't get it. It's gonna take to the Most High God really start judging this earth for y'all to see it. But it's okay, because it's already happening now. Go to Matthew 24. Let's show you some of the prophecies Christ was talking about when he walked the earth. When he was gearing his disciples to go teach. Go ahead, start at verse 3.
Matthew chapter 24 and verse 3. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?
So the disciples said, what's the signs of the end of the world? Pay attention.
And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name.
He said, first off, take heed that nobody deceives you, because many gonna come in the name of Christ, aka Christianity, having nothing to do with Christ and what he really taught. Go ahead.
Saying, I am Christ.
Oh yeah, they gonna say, oh yeah, brother. The Church of Christ is right here. We teach the truth. But no, every Christian I know living wickedly and don't want to change. Go ahead.
And shall deceive many.
Uh-huh.
And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars.
Yep.
See that ye be not troubled.
So you're gonna have wars and hear rumors of wars. That's everything everybody talking about. World War III about to happen. World War III about to happen. It's in y'all spirit already. Y'all just need to wake up and understand what's going on for real. Go ahead.
For all these things must come to pass.
Uh-huh.
But the end is not yet.
Go ahead.
For nation shall rise against nation.
What does that mean? Nation shall rise up against nation. That means nationality against nationality.
Right.
Stop trying to stand together with these white folks. Stop trying to stick up for the Asian man. Stick with your people. So-called blacks and Latinos, you are the same people. We hate each other when the whole world hate us, but we want to love them. What type of sense does that make? We got to come together. We got to gear ourselves up for war. Because while y'all sitting there trying to look pretty, you know what the white girls is doing? They getting taught by their daddies how to shoot AKs and ARs. 9mm. They know how to reload a gun. When our sister's scared of a damn spider, how you gonna be ready for war? When all you worry about is getting your nipples pierced, looking cute for some dudes who ain't worth nothing. You see how vain we are? Probably not, because y'all laughing, but read on.
For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom.
What you gonna do when money ain't worth nothing? What you gonna do when all your racks that you've been saving up from the strip club ain't worth nothing? When you can't go out and get your nails done no more, let alone provide for your children. You can't buy no more milk. You can't buy no more groceries. What are you gonna do? Read.
And there shall be famines and pestilences.
Famine. famines and pestilences. We in a famine and this great pestilence is going around right now. Have y'all looked up Venezuela? The people over there going mad because their economy collapsed. They can't even afford eggs over there. But see, America, they know how to throw a great show. Here we are in LA, they got the BET experience. They make you feel like you this close to stardom and fame when you broke, don't even know who you are. That's real poverty. Being deprived of who you are. Not knowing your ancestors and your history. Pestilences, all the disease going around. Famine, how is it that all the food being produced is GMO? Them strawberries you eating on was produced in a laboratory. Wasn't even grown in a field. That's happening right now. Wake up, go ahead.
And earthquakes in diverse places.
Earthquakes. What was that earthquake got a couple months ago, killed like 400 people? Can't think of the name. But everybody's talking about that big one that's supposed to hit Cali. We living in the end of times. We don't have that much time to keep messing around. You gotta get right. Most High God is sending his prophets out here to prophesy unto you what's gonna happen. You gotta listen. Because believe it or not, everybody not going to the kingdom of heaven. I brought it out last week. Give me 2 Ezra chapter 8, verse 3. No, 8 and 1. Go ahead.
2 Ezra chapter 8, verse 1. And he answered me, saying, the Most High hath made this world for many.
God said he made this world for many people. There's billions of people on the face of this earth, right? Go ahead.
But the world to come.
The world to come is talking about that kingdom of heaven.
For few.
For few. Go ahead. Go to verse 3.
Verse 3. There be many created, but few shall be saved.
Many people created, but few shall be saved. That needs to concern you heavily. What's your nationality, man? You've been listening. What's your nationality?
Irish and Polish.
Irish and Polish? Okay.
White and white.
But nonetheless, our people, most rebellious. We don't want to get the word. Give me 2 Ezra chapter 9, verse 11.
2 Ezra chapter 9, verse 11. And they that have loathed my law, while they had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, understood not.
See, our people, we have a chance to repent right now. But y'all walking by with deaf ears and blind eyes like you don't see us out here teaching, telling you to repent, keep God's laws. It says you have the time for that right now, but you don't understand. But go ahead.
But despised it.
You despise it.
The same must know it after death.
The same. You people who don't want to listen, you have to know that you messed up after death.
By pain.
By pain. You're going to be in them hell flames forever because you was too hard-headed and stubborn to listen. And said, you know what? What them brothers are saying is true. They reading out the Bible. Our people, we don't get it, though. We think that America is everything to life. Clubbing, partying, getting a good job. We think that's all it is. It's nothing more. But you've been deceived. Give me Sirach 11. Chapter 11, verse 21. How you doing, brother?
I'm doing blessed, brother.
That's good to hear.
Do and keep up the good work.
That's right. Check this out.
Sirach, chapter 11, verse 21. Marvel not at the works of sinners.
See, we're not supposed to marvel at the works of sinners. Sisters right here, y'all be amazed at how much jewelry and money rappers got. Y'all like them flashy cars they be driving? Yes, you do. Don't lie. Don't lie. But go ahead and read it again.
Marvel not at the works of sinners.
God said, don't marvel at the works of sinners. We shouldn't be here to see Chris Brown and all them fools. What they doing for you? They telling you that you're not loyal and that y'all hoes for everybody.
That's right.
Didn't he say that?
He said.
Yes, he did. Y'all shouldn't be marveling about these clowns. Read.
But trust in the Lord.
But trust in the Lord. Because the Lord, he's looking out for you the long way. Chris Brown didn't wake you up this morning. God did. Read.
But trust
in the Lord. You said what? You are wrong. Give me Leviticus 19:15. No, stay right here. Stay right here. No, stay right here. Hurry up. Read that.
Leviticus chapter 19 and verse 15.
Go ahead.
You shall do no unrighteous judgment.
No, read it again.
You shall do no unrighteousness in judgment.
God said, you shall do no unrighteousness in judgment. Go ahead.
Thou shalt not respect the person of the poor.
Don't respect the person of the poor when it comes to judgment.
Nor honor the person of the mighty.
Nor honor the person of the mighty. These celebrities, none of them is exempt. God said you're supposed to judge. That's how you fix your people.
Amen.
But go back to Sirach. So God said, don't marvel at the works of sinners.
Marvel not at the works of sinners, but trust in the Lord and abide in thy labor. For it is an easy thing in the sight of the Lord on the sudden to make a poor man rich.
You see, that's our people. That's all we worried about, is just being rich. God said it's an easy thing for him to make you rich, but that's not profitable unto you. Be rich in spirit first. Understand who you are. Understand you have a culture outside of hip hop and drug popping. There's more to it than that, Reed.
The blessing of the Lord is in the reward of the godly.
You see, God, he blesses the godly people, not those who sin.
Do you have on that station?
Native Americans,
we gonna tell the truth. We gonna tell the truth today. What kind of crap do you have on PT? You don't have anything that's uplifting our people.
Because I'm going to
say what the real with you. The thing is, our people we love.
We love to entertain.
Who should be getting put to death every time somebody dies? Stuff that's happening to blacks and Latinos throughout the United States, throughout Central and South America.